right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay, just let me share this one. Okay, yes, some of you are asking me that in some books, V1 by V2 equals to K is written. And yesterday, actually, Shubham called me. And he also sent me one snapshot that in that book, V1 by V2 equals to K is written. Right. So first, before starting that your voltage regulation portion, so let me clear that part first. Okay. So how to write that referred to primary or referred to secondary portion? Who is calling now? Just a minute. Hello. Okay, just a minute. Okay, please check, is the screen visible here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay. Hey, ma'am, হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ ওটাই দিয়ে দিন না, ওটাই দিয়ে দিন তাহলে। তা নাহলে আপনাকে আবার নতুন করে কোশ্চেন সেট করে নিতে হবে। হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, আমি তাহলে আজকে ওর সাথে কথা বলে নিচ্ছি বিকেলবেলা, আর আপনি ওটাই দিয়ে দিন তাহলে। হ্যাঁ 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 ঠিক আছে, ঠিক আছে ম্যাম। ওকে ওকে, সো ফার্স্ট ওকে, সো টুডে উই উইল ডিসকাস দিস ওয়ান, দ্য বেসিক কনসেপ্ট অফ টার্ন রেশিও। ওকে, সি I am considering two cases, right? Is the screen visible? Please check again.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So, yes, any problem? Okay, fine. So, I am considering, right? Okay, who is there? So I am considering here two cases. First case, when V1 by V2 equals to K. Okay. And okay, so this one is basically wrong. So I am not writing it as K. I am writing as A. Okay. And V2 by V1, which is actually the turn ratio as per rule, I am writing it as K. Okay. Now, what I already know, V1 by V2 equals to N1 by N2 equals to I2 by I1. Okay. Equals to A. If I am considering this case, okay, I am discussing two cases individually, okay, so that you don't have any problem whatever case was considered by the book. Clear? So first case I am considering where V1 by V2 equals to A, and I know that V1 by V2 equals to N1 by N2 and the current will be opposite. I2 by I1 equals to A, right? So now I am writing, please check whether it is understandable or not. V2 by I2, okay? I am writing it as Z1 by Z2. Is it clear? Please check, this one is clear or not. V1 by I1 equals to Z1, V2 by I2 equals to Z2. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now I am writing this one, V1 by V2 into I2 by I1. Okay, is this okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Now, V1 by V2, I already know this is A. Okay, and I2 by I1, this value is also A. So, this is Z1 by Z2. Clear? So, now Z2, I can write it as Z1 by A square. Okay, that means what? You are converting from secondary to primary. Right? Z2 to Z1. Okay? Now, so here, suppose this is known to you, here one resistance is here. Okay? One resistance is here in the secondary and this is your primary. Okay, so now here Z2 value is known to you. So from here, if it, you are calculating referred to primary, okay, referred referred, referred to primary, okay, then this is your construction now, right? This is your primary, this is your secondary, this is your primary, this is your secondary, okay? So I am writing it as Z2 dash. So what will be the value of Z2 dash? Z2 dash will be A square into Z2. Is this clear? Because here Z1 is the referred value. Okay. As per your calculation, you can manipulate this equation. This is the only equation you have to remember. And if you cannot remember, follow these instructions. Follow these steps. I hope it is that not that much tough to remember. Okay. So, here, as per the rule, Z1, that is referred to primary value, Z1 referred to primary value is A square into Z2. Okay. Now, if Z1 is given and you need to calculate the referred to secondary value, then how will it be? It will be Z2 referred to secondary equals to Z1 by A square. Is the concept clear? Please check. Okay? Because I am considering this rule. You can check the book also. Now, considering this rule, how will this calculation change? See, same process again. V1 by I1 divided by V2 by I2. Okay. Equals to, I can write as Z1 by Z2. Clear? So from here, I can write V1 by V2 into I2 by I1. See, the process is same, only your values will be different, just a little bit different. Okay, now check here, this V1 by V2 equals to 1 by K, right? What is I2 by I1? That is also 1 by K, right? Equals to Z1 by Z2. Okay, so from here I am getting what? Z2 equals to A square into Z1. Now here same condition, same case, Z1, that means your referred to primary value, referred to primary value, that means your Z2 is given and you have to calculate referred to primary value. So Z1 you need to calculate, that means this equation will be Z2 by K square. Okay, now if it is given Z2, that means referred to secondary value, referred to secondary value, this will be Z2 value you need to find out, so it will be K square into Z1. Okay, now whatever formula you want to use, always remember this equation. See, remember this one. This one is very important. In no book you will get this. Okay, if you consider any foreign author book, then you will get this concept. It is very basic concept. Okay, check everyone, if any problem you are facing, tell me now. Is it okay to everyone, or if you want to take a snapshot, you can take. Okay, done?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Koi confusion nahi hai? Clear ho gaya?
Yes sir.
Okay, so whatever book you have, whatever system you follow, you will get the same equation, same value. Okay, now we will discuss the voltage regulation. Okay, voltage regulation. Now how many types of voltage regulations are there? Three types based on the load connected. So first, if we connect, so three cases, lagging power factor, okay, second leading, and third, the last one is the unity power factor. Okay, that means for three types of load we are going to discuss the voltage regulation. Okay, so if we discuss the lagging case, then this is your total primary, okay, this is your coil. See, I am spending much more time for this transformer section, okay, because you will get maximum number of numerical based on this transformer, that means maximum marks question, maybe 10 marks question is given in exam based on transformer. Okay, so I want you to solve this type of numerical. Okay, that's why I am spending much more time, so that if you have any kind of doubt, ask me. Okay, now I am adding the resistor and inductor because I want to create the voltage regulation for lagging condition. Okay, so this is your R, this is your L, and this is the secondary. Okay, so I am writing here R2 and L2. Fine. Now this is the voltage here, V2. Okay, fine. Now here V2 voltage is there. Now lagging power factor is possible here because inductor is connected. Now current flowing here is I2. Okay, so our main objective is to find out E2. Okay, okay, just a minute. Here one thing is, here this is your R2 plus JX2, okay, and here it is called the load. Okay, that means instead of R2 we need to write here the RL, or you can say ZL, which is equal to RL plus JXL, okay, or whatever be the load, no issue. And across that load, V2 is the value that you can measure from the multimeter. Okay, so first V2 value is the full loaded condition and E2 is the no load condition. So what is the voltage regulation equation? So voltage regulation means no load voltage, that means E2, minus full load voltage, that means V2. Okay, now what is the percentage voltage regulation? Percentage voltage regulation means E2 minus V2 divided by V2, okay, into 100%. So this is your percentage regulation with respect to the full load case. Okay, now phasor diagram, how can we calculate this? V2 is known to us, so I am putting V2 as here the reference, right? Now since inductor is connected in everywhere, so I2 will be lagging, right? So I2 is lagging by angle theta 2. Okay, so what is the power factor in secondary? Tell me. What is the power factor in secondary? What should I write?
So cos theta 2.
Exactly. So it is cos theta 2. Okay. So now see, I2 into R2 is there. So if resistance is present, okay, the voltage drop across the resistance, if you calculate, it must be always in phase. So I2 and the parallel line I will draw, which will detect I2 into R2. Okay, because the direction of current I2, whatever be the direction of current I2, and the voltage loss across the resistor, if there is resistor, then I2 into R2, they must be in phase always, right? And if one inductor is there, it always will be perpendicular to the direction of I2. Okay, so this is your I2 into XL2, or here X2. So here, what is the 90 degree? This is the 90 degree direction. Okay, this is the 90 degree direction. So whatever value is here, it is called the I2 into X2. Clear? So this is your phasor diagram total. And if this all phasors are added, we will get the value of E2. Okay, so now I am joining this section, this line by this line, these phasors by this line. So whatever you are observing here, this is the value of E2. Okay, is the construction clear? Please check. Is the construction clear?
No, sir.
Sir, please explain again.
Okay. See, here V2 I am putting as the reference, right? So if V2 is our reference and inductor is present in the system, so I2 will be lagging. Okay, so that's why I have drawn I2 as theta 2 angle lagging. Okay, now if current is flowing here, okay, I is here through one resistor only, current I is flowing. Okay, so one voltage drop V equals to IR will be developed, right? And I told you that if resistor is present, then the voltage drop V must be in phase with the current. Do you remember this one?
Yes, sir.
You remember this
Yes.
one? Okay, so here also that is happening. Here I2 is present. Okay, and this I2 current is flowing through this R2. Okay, so that's why a certain voltage loss in secondary across the resistor will appear, and that must be in phase with the I2. Okay, so that's why I2 is here. So VR2, I2 into R2 must be in phase also. Right, and this one is shifted here. Now, is it clear? This I2 R2 section, this I2 R2, which is in phase with I2, is shifted here. This line is I2 R2, this line.
So why?
Okay. Just a minute, let me explain. See, this is your current. Okay. This is your voltage across R. Okay. Now, a certain voltage already is present here. Fine. Suppose this is your V1. Already one voltage is present here. So, total voltage, how will you calculate? You have to add the phasor VR with V1, right? So how will you add? Either you add VR like this and do the resultant, okay? Or you will do here VR is present, you will add V1 here and do the resultant. In both case, you will get the same resultant, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
I am doing that concept. I am, yes.
Sir, it's according to the vector law. We can see
Yes, that is according to the vector
vector
law.
law. Yes, sir.
It is voltage. Okay? And I have to add the voltage with voltage only. So that's why I am moving this I2 R2 vector in parallel with I2 and added with V2. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Here I2 R2 is present, and when current is flowing through the inductor, then it will be 90 degree perpendicular with respect to I2 R2. Okay, so that's why with respect to I2 R2 is present like this. This is your I2 R2. Okay, and then I am expanding the in 90 degree angle. So that is drawn here. This concept is used here. Okay. Then I am drawing, I have drawn the resultant, that is the E2 value. Is the phasor clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So basically, what we are doing, we are first always we are drawing the V2, then current we are going to draw, okay? Then I2 R2 value we are going to put, right? and then in 90 degree angle we will add the I2XL or I2X2, right? I2X2. This is the just vector addition. Okay, then we will draw the resultant. So this is the value of E2. Okay, so now what is the final voltage regulation equation? The voltage regulation equation, if you calculate this one, E2 minus V2, if you calculate, you will see that the final voltage regulation becomes I2 into R2 cos theta 2 plus I2 into X2 sine theta 2. See this equation, how this equation is you will get this equation. The calculation process is not in the syllabus. Okay, if you want, I will show you, but it is not actually needed. Okay, just you have to remember how this V2 and E2 are drawn, the phasor diagram. Okay, divided by V2. So that is the percentage voltage regulation into 100%. Okay, so that is the basic process. That is the equation, the voltage regulation equation. Already it is written in the PPT also. Don't worry, I will give that. Right, so that is the lagging power factor. Next, we will discuss the leading power factor. So first, what we are going to do? We are going to draw the transformer first. Okay, this is the code section. Then this is the primary. Okay, this one is the secondary, right? And if we want to use to get the leading power factor, then what should I write here? Z2 equals to R2 minus JXC. Okay, JXC2, that means here capacitor is used. Okay, now here V2 value is already, you know, V2 value will appear across the load. Okay, across the disconnected. Okay, this is the E2 value and current flowing is I2. Right, this is your primary, this is your secondary. Clear? So now first, V2 is known because we can calculate that from the multimeter. Now here current I2 will be leading with respect to V2 because I have used the capacitor. So current will be in leading position. So here I am drawing current I2 here. Okay, see, it is leading with respect to V2. I am writing it as theta 2. This is your V2. Okay, now this I2 is flowing through the resistance R2. Okay, because here resistance is present. Okay, and capacitor is present. So for that resistor, if current is flowing like this, voltage will always be in phase. Right, this is your I, this is your VR, and if current is flowing like this, then VC will be like this. Okay, so just like that, here I2 into R2. Okay, this is your I2 into R2. Okay, and as per this I2 is concerned, V2 will be 90 degree lagging like this. So you will get this type. Okay, so ultimately this will be your final value. Okay, is the construction clear? Please check. Okay, so that is the leading power factor. Okay, so this is the leading power factor. In some book also you will see like this. Okay, in some book you can also see a system like this. This is your V2. Okay, this is your leading power factor I2, leading current I2, angle is theta 2. Okay, and I2 R2 is present like this. This is your I2 into R2. Okay, but current is leading. Okay, but here in this position, if they used R XL, okay, in place of Z2, in place of Z2, they used the XL, but current is ultimately leading. Okay, this is your XL2. So at that time you will see this kind of configuration. Okay, so your final, this will be your E. This kind of system you may see in some book. Okay, both are actually correct. Here I am creating a circuit, a secondary, where all the elements are only resistance and the capacitors. Okay, but here in some book they have used the R2, that means inductor, that means resistor, inductor and capacitor here in this load section. Okay, and that capacitance value is much higher, so that the current becomes leading. Okay, so that is the main process of leading power factor. Okay, now next one is the unity power factor. So unity power factor means where V2 is there, I2 is also in phase. Clear? So now we will discuss the unity power factor. Okay, so in unity power factor, what will happen? Unity power factor V2 is here. Okay, since power factor is unity, here I2 will be present. Okay, now since I2 is here, so I2 R2 will always be in phase, right? This is your I2 R2. Then some inductor is present also. So ultimately you will get, this is your E2. Okay, now I2 R2, this will be your I2 XL. Okay, so that is your unity power factor. That means the main, your objective is to place the V2 and I2 properly. Okay, main your objective is to V2 and I2 properly. So this is your unity power factor. Now if leading power factor is here, so leading power factor voltage regulation equation will be I2 R2 cos theta 2, right, minus I2 x2 sine theta 2 divided by V2 into 100%. So this is the percentage voltage regulation for the leading power factor. That means the current is leading with respect to the secondary voltage. Here, this is the voltage regulation for lagging power factor. That means the voltage and current, in between that, current is lagging with respect to secondary voltage. Here, the current is lagging with respect to secondary voltage. So that is our main objective. Okay. Here also, see, the current is leading because I am considering leading power factor. So current is leading with respect to V2. Next, this is the unity power factor. Okay. So unity power factor means V2 and I2 will always be in series. Okay. Clear? So now I am going to the here. Just a minute. Okay. So this is the lagging power factor concept. This is the calculation of lagging power factor. I have already shown you. Okay. If any problem is there, you can check. But this calculation is not in your syllabus, right? So this is your voltage regulation. You can see E2 minus V2 divided by V2. And what is the equation? Equation is I2 R2 cos theta 2 plus I2 X2 sin theta 2 divided by V2. And if leading is here, if leading concept you want to write, this is the lagging power factor concept. If you calculate the leading voltage regulation, then only this sign will be minus. Only this sign will be minus. Okay. Now, look here. The only sign is getting changed here. Okay. At zero power factor, that means at unity power factor. Okay. Here, another one is zero voltage regulation. Another one is unit voltage regulation. Two things are different. Here it is zero power factor. That means what? That means there is no difference between the no load voltage and full load voltage. Okay. That is the zero power factor. That means zero voltage regulation. Zero voltage regulation means here it is your E2 minus V2 divided by V2 equals to zero. So that means what? From here you can calculate that you will get that E2 equals to V2. That means in between this E2 and V2 there is no difference, so that the voltage regulation becomes zero. Okay. Now when this voltage regulation becomes unity, so right here E2 minus V2 divided by V2 equals to 1. So at that time, when E2 becomes 2V2, then you will get the full voltage regulation or unit voltage regulation. Okay. So now, what is the condition for voltage zero voltage regulation? So zero voltage regulation we can calculate like this, because our approximate voltage regulation equation is this one. Okay. I2 R2 cos theta 2, I2 X E2 sin theta 2. Why E is written? That means if any resistance is in primary, if we convert that into secondary, if we refer that to secondary, then the total resistance becomes RE2. That means RE2 you can write as R2 plus r1 dash. Okay, similarly, xe2 you can write as x2 plus x1 dash. So if r1 dash and x1 dash values are 0, so this re2 will be converted into r2, xe2 will be converted into x2. Okay, so for zero voltage regulation, this becomes equal to 0, right? So from here you can calculate the theta 2 angle, so that you can say that at this angle you will get the zero voltage regulation. Okay, that is the process, that is I2 RE2 into cos theta 2 plus I2 XE2 sin theta 2 equals to 0. And for what angle this value is you will get this value at theta 2 angle after this calculation. Okay, the value is minus tan inverse RE2 by XE2. So if you can develop a certain condition that theta 2 equals to this one, so at this value, at this theta 2 angle, you will get the zero voltage regulation. Okay, next, maximum voltage regulation, when it is possible. The maximum voltage regulation will be possible if d d theta 2 of total regulation becomes 0. That means you have to put the maximum minimum condition. If you take the differentiation of the total equation with respect to theta 2, then whatever value you get from there, the condition that is developed, that is the maximum voltage regulation condition, like this here, dd theta 2 of I e2 r e2 cos theta 2 plus I2, sorry, this will be I2 xe2 sin theta 2 divided by v2. Okay, now if you do the differentiation, this equation you will get, that is equal to 0 as per the maxima equation. Okay, so from there you will get the theta 2 value as tan inverse xe2 by re2 equals to theta 2. So you can calculate the power factor. Okay, if this angle is 60 degree or 30 degree, so that you can say that at 60 degree the voltage regulation becomes maximum, or cos 60 equals to half. Okay, so that you can say that the when the power factor is 0.5, you will get the maximum voltage regulation. Okay, so that is the main concept of voltage regulation here. Okay, so I am stopping here. So if you have any doubt, you can ask, and everyone give your attendance in the chat box.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, for zero voltage, why we have taken, sir, lagging concept only, sir? Lagging
concept. See, zero voltage regulation you can get for any power factor condition. Okay. But in basic case, see, all our home appliances are mainly working in induction process. Okay, that means induction oven. And if you see the bulb, there is also one coil. So coil is basically inductor. The lagging power factor it will generate. So if by default we are choosing, if we are choosing anything, we will always take the lagging concept, because you will see all the instrument, all the appliances you are using, they are mainly the giving the lagging concept only, not leading. Okay, if you choose, suppose if you choose just take that your fan, okay, there is one coil in the rotor. So that coil is what? what the form of inductor, right? Okay, next example, if you take induction oven, if you open that induction oven, the backside of the induction oven, you will see that there is a big round of coil is there. So that is also inductor. So basically, whatever load we are consuming, that is active load, and the power factor due to our appliances is mainly the lagging power factor. Okay, so that's why by default we always choose the lagging conditions. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. And is your query clear, Shubham, that V1 by V2 equals to K or V2 by V1 equals to K?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, so thank you, everyone. And if you have any question, you can ask. And those who have given their attendances, they may leave the meeting. Your class is officially over.
Good sir.
Haan, Shubham, bolo.
Sir, Adita was there in the class, but few minutes ago her battery like became, so she left the class, so for the attendance she told me.
Okay, who is, okay, the name?
Adita Pathak.
Adita Pathak, okay, okay, fine, fine.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, in, okay, tell her to inform me, okay?
Okay, okay, sir, okay, sir.
Okay, fine, thank you. Okay, so thank you, everyone. I am leaving the meeting. Thank you.